Describe image. A brown dog with a pink collar is playing with a blue toy. The dog is lying on its side and its paw is resting on the toy.
TalkBack and Android can provide automatic descriptions of icons and images, and it can also give AI descriptions using Gemini. Let's talk about it. Hi everyone, welcome to Carry On Accessibility, where we talk about tech and accessibility. TalkBack has these AI kind of features for descriptions, and I wanted to go over how to turn them on, how I have mine set up, as well as how I think they could be improved. If you agree with me or disagree with me, I would love to hear from you. Leave those in the comments. Before we go on, I want to give a big, huge thank you to Alan Tharp for becoming a Koa Epic Ally member. Thank you so much, as well as to Ken and Hank Abma for becoming Koa members. Koa members make these videos possible. All right, so here we go. Here's my Pixel 8 Pro. Make sure you always keep your Android accessibility suite on the Play Store updated. This is going to be slightly different on Samsung, and the TalkBack updates with the OS. So first we're going to go to TalkBack settings. I'm going to do a 3-finger tap to bring up the TalkBack menu.
Actions. TalkBack settings.
And I'm just going to touch. I know where the TalkBack settings are generally, so I'm going to double tap there.
TalkBack settings. Navigate up.
Now we're going to go through this menu.
Navigate up. New features in Talk Audio. Text to speech setting. Verbosity. Sound and vibe controls. Customize focus. Customize menus. Cover proximity, image and icon, braille, image and icon descriptions.
There it is. We're going to double tap there.
Image and icon descriptions. Get detailed AI image descriptions when you select describe image from the TalkBack menu. You can also get automatic descriptions when you focus on an image or icon. Automatic descriptions work without an internet connection.
We're going to swipe.
Detailed image descriptions, off.
We're going to turn this on.
Detailed image descriptions, powered by generative AI. Detailed image descriptions. When using this feature, selected images will be sent to Google for processing and then deleted. Generative AI is experimental, so it will make mistakes. By continuing, you agree to Google's terms of service. Turn on.
We're going to turn this on.
Image and icon descriptions. Navigate up. Automatic image descriptions. Unlabeled images only.
You can have automatic image descriptions. I like to just keep this for when it doesn't have a label.
Automatic icon descriptions, unlabeled icons only.
I also like the same setting for icons.
Automatic descriptions for text and images, all images.
For text and images, I like to actually have that always on because sometimes text and images, even like alt text, people don't always write what the text in the image is. But if we go back.
Automatic image descriptions, unlabeled images only.
I'm going to double tap here just so that we can see the different options.
Automatic image descriptions. Downloaded. Hear descriptions when you focus on an image. Some apps may not support this.
If this is your first time using this, you may need to download some information from Google for it to be able to do all this processing.
Not selected. All images.
So you can select all images.
Selected. Unlabeled images only.
Unlabeled images only.
Not selected. Don't describe images.
Or don't describe. So I'm going to keep the setting that I had. And for icons, you have these same options.
Photo taken on February 14th, 2025, 9:26 a.m.
Here I am on a photo in Google Photos, and I want this to be described. So I'm going to tap with 3 fingers.
TalkBack menu. Describe image.
And we can double tap on describe image.
Detected image. A brown dog with a pink collar is playing with a blue toy. The dog is lying on its side and its paw is resting on the toy. The dog's head is tilted to the side and its eyes are closed. The toy is a blue ball with a hole in the middle. The dog is on a gray mat. The dog's ears are floppy and its fur is short. The dog looks like it is having fun. Icon, pause. Close.
I don't know what icon pause is. It's detecting something photos. There. You can also customize a gesture to do describe image. For me, I have 3-finger, triple tap and hold. So I'll do the same thing, maybe in a
photo
different
taken
picture.
On February 14th, yes. Automatic description.
Let's try this picture.
Detected. Image. A close-up of a light brown and tan dog with pink collar and a blue bowl. The dog is looking down at the bowl and appears to be sniffing it. The dog's paws are visible on the sides of the bowl. The background is a dark gray, possibly a mat or floor.
Every time you use the describe image feature, it does bring up this little pop-up, and you will need to...
Icon. Close.
Close it.
Photos.
This works on anything that TalkBack can focus on, and it does so by taking a screenshot or partial screenshot of the focused item. For example, I can go to
YouTube.
This is my home screen. I'll go to YouTube and have it describe the YouTube icon.
Play Store. Detected. Image. The image is a white circle with a red YouTube logo in the center. The YouTube logo is a red rectangle with rounded corners and a white play button in the middle.
And there you go.
Close.
Now I'm on Instagram. I found this like random product image.
Photo 1 of 10 by Timu Official. 401 likes. Selfie please. Take a quick look.
Okay.
Nova launcher. Stop. Home.
Photo I'm going to focus on the image. And now I'm going to have it describe.
Detected. Image. The image shows a woman wearing a black and green dress with a hood. The dress is fitted in the bodice and flares out at the hem, where it has a layer of green ruffles. The dress is a zipper down the front, and the hood has a drawstring. The woman is wearing a silver necklace with a star pendant. The dress is casual and comfortable, and would be perfect for a day out or a night out. Close.
So this one seems to be a video, and of course doesn't have any description, so I'm going to describe that one.
Detected. Image. The image shows a person drawing on a piece of paper with a paintbrush. They are following a guide with multiple images of different shapes and arrows on the paper. The paintbrush they are using is dipped in rainbow-colored paint, which is probably from the makeup palette in the top left corner of the image. The background is a wooden table.
Oh.
Text and image. And Kapila Oslo. And Cabela. Veronica.
I'm not so sure about that detected text, but okay.
Close.
I haven't gotten describe image to work on my S25 Ultra, unfortunately. You can use the automatic descriptions for images, icons, and text and images. However, the describe image feature that I kind of demoed on the Pixel, I can't seem to get to work at all on the same cell. So that's currently how TalkBack's AI descriptions work, describe image. And while it's great, I would really love it if they could add more improvements. I love that it's already part of TalkBack and you don't need to share the image to something like Be My Eyes or something else. So that's really, really neat. However, number one, I wish I could do this even without TalkBack. Descriptions would still be super helpful for me when I'm not using TalkBack. But even with TalkBack on or without, I would love to have a way to ask follow-up questions. There's already a pop-up that opens and it could be super easy to just have a button there to ask a follow-up question. And if there was a way to do the whole screen instead of just what TalkBack can focus on, because there are some apps where you just can't focus on anything, that would be really awesome. Taking it a step further, wouldn't it be great if, you know, if there was an app that wasn't accessible and it can do something like screen recognition on iOS where it can recognize or try to recognize what the app is and how it works and then let you tap on things. So you can like AI the screen and then you can use Explore by Touch, swipe through different things and it can use AI to describe stuff. Now that would be awesome. Hopefully Google is working on some of these, at least some follow-up questions and being able to take full screenshots and have those described. That would be really awesome if they were. But yeah, let me know what you think in the comments. Are you using this feature? Is it helpful for you? If you like this video, give it a thumbs up below. Subscribe for more content like this. And if you want to support the channel and what I do, consider becoming a Koa member on YouTube or Patreon. You can get exclusive videos, we have member-only giveaways, and we have Koa meetups every month, and more. Check it out in the links below. Thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you in the next video.